fans, I'm Boyd Pierce, and welcome to Mid-South Wrestling. Another exciting card this week. We hope you'll stay with us all the way. One of the matches will be the Junkyard Dog against Mr. Olympia. And the new North American Heavyweight Champion Hacksaw Butch Reed defends his title against the challenge of Magnum T.A. Lots of great wrestlers, adds up to a lot of excitement and action. The men to tell us about it, the fine sports director from KALB Channel 5 in Alexandria, Louisiana, Buddy Nichols. Buddy?
Thank you, Boyd. Nice to be back again with you this week. An action-packed hour. Looks like it's going to be a good card.
It is, and the contestants are in the ring, so let's go for the introduction. We'll be right back.
And it's tag team action now for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. In the red corner, at 227 pounds from Los Angeles, California, Rip Rogers. And his partner at 260 pounds from Rome, Georgia, Tony Zane. In the blue corner at 238 pounds from Indianapolis, Indiana, George Weingraub. And his partner at 222 pounds from Knoxville, Tennessee, Tim Horner.
Tag team action starts it off as Tony Zane and Rip Rogers over in the far corner against Tim Horner. And the man left in the ring to start the action in the red tights, George Weingraub. Joel Armstrong calls for the bell. George Weingraub, fine amateur, great from the University of Tennessee at Chattanooga, coming from the state of Indiana, his birthplace. Buddy, tell us about it.
Okay, Boyd. Also point out, too, that George Weingraub really had a little bit of a disadvantage, legally blind in one eye, so he really has to make up a lot of courage and a big heart to overcome that disadvantage that he does have. But right now, he and his partner, Tim Horner, in control of the match. Early part, first one fall, 10-minute time limit. Nice flying body press by Horner, but Rip Rogers out of Los Angeles, California, is able to kick out of it. And again, back on the attack quickly, the speedy youngster from the University of Tennessee over in Knoxville, Tennessee, Tim Horner. He tags out quickly to Reingroff. And nice reversal by the Californian. And again, Rogers off the ropes, holds on quickly. And Horner slaps him on the back of the head. And Weingraub promptly meets him with a flying drop kick. Good move. He got his mind on Horner, and then Weingraub took advantage of it and got the flying drop kick off. Now Tony Zane in the middle. Zane out of Rome, Georgia, in the purple tights, lavender. And Horner back in now.
Buddy, the fans at home and the fans here at the Irish McNeil Boys Club in Shreveport, where the taping is done, are viewing four fine young grapplers.
They have a lot of future in front of them. Of course, Weingraub, wrestling tradition from a few years back. His father saw Weingraub in the wrestling business a long, long time, so a lot of tradition passed down there. And all of these young men have good amateur background, so they are well on their way to being stars of the future in the squared circle. And we're seeing some of that action right now. George Weingraub in the red trunks, in control of the match over Tony Zane. He has Zane down on the canvas, has the arm barred. Joel Armstrong, fine young referee, checks with Zane. Zane, of course, not about to give it up, not in a pinning combination, of course, and not in a submission. But they're working on that left arm and that left shoulder area as Horner quickly on the tag, and he comes in and takes right up where Weingraub left off. Again, the good teamwork by Horner and Weingraub. They're keeping Zane in pain and in trouble. Nice fireman carry takedown by Weingraub. And Zane trying to get over to his corner to tag Rip Rogers, but Weingraub trying to keep that from happening, but cannot any longer, as they get Weingraub over in their corner. And now they go to work on him. Again, the reversal. Off the ropes, Rip Rogers goes underneath, and he comes off with a big elbow off the ropes, meeting Weingraub. Snap mare down, count of one, and that is all that he can get on Weingraub, as Rogers and Zane now try to do a little teamwork on George Weingraub. They throw him right back into the turnbuckle in the upper back area on that top turnbuckle. Again, a pinning combination, but only one. As Zane and Rip Rogers working on the man in the ring, George Weingroff. Rogers goes to the second rope now, wants the big elbow, and he missed it. Weingroff quickly up, trying to get over to Horner. Makes the tag, and Horner in quickly. A big right hand, a nice forearm to the side of the face. Into the ropes, a high flip off the rope, and Horner drops down with one knee, that left knee on the top of the head, and that sends Rip Rogers to the tag and Tony Zane in. Now the double team is Rogers and Zane, double team Horner, but quickly Weingroff into the action now. We've got all four of them in there. Horner working on Zane, Weingroff working on Rip Rogers, and they meet each other in the middle as Rip Rogers and Tony Zane bump in the middle of the squared circle. Now the double drop, and Rip Rogers out of the ring on the near side. Now they're gonna go to Tony Zane. They flip him in, a double flip back over. And Weingroff and Tim Horner working good together right now. Good teamwork by the youngsters. Indianapolis, Indiana, and Knoxville, Tennessee working together here. Rogers back up on the apron now. The abdominal stretch, roll him into a pinning combination. Zane cannot get out of it. 1, 2, 3.
And the winners, George Weingroff and Tim Horner, start things off this week with a victory. We'll be back. Hacksaw Jim Duggan in action after this message.
This event is for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. In the red corner at 250 pounds from Fort Worth, Texas, Rick Davidson. And in the blue corner at 275 pounds from New York City, Hacksaw Duggan.
Introduction now, the big man in blue from Fort Worth, Texas, Rick Davidson, against big foot stomping New Yorker, the popular now, Hacksaw Jim Duggan.
Well, boy, my first opportunity to see Rick Davidson in action. Of course, Jim Duggan, his reputation follows him wherever he goes, a man who has no regard for his own body and very little for others. He really gets into it. He is a outstanding athlete, former football player, as you know, from the University of Southern Methodist over in Dallas, Texas. Of course, a former professional football player for the Atlanta Falcons, and right now he is really controlling Rick Davidson. Davidson tries to get a little rest as he wants to reevaluate his attack on big Hacksaw Jim Duggan. Back into the ring now. Duggan just kind of looks at him, says, "Step back, referee Johnny Martinez, and let me have my way, and I'll take care of matters in hand." Duggan behind, now takes him down. And again, Davidson looking for a little safety and retreating to the rope. And Duggan can't stand it, so a little kick quickly as he gets up, runs him into the near turnbuckle, stuns Davidson momentarily, and Hacksaw Jim Duggan has his eyes raked by Davidson, and that may make matters worse, Boyd. Again, Davidson with the rake of the eyes. And Duggan has the foot stomping going, and he is upset.
That's what you call stirring up a hornet after the hornet's already stirred up.
That's right. That's what you call making a hot pot boiling even hotter. And Duggan really taking control now. Gets into that three-point stance that made him so dangerous. And there's the spear. And he has the two count, the three count, and Duggan, the winner over Davidson.
And we'll be back. The Junkyard Dog versus Mr. Olympia. Don't miss it. We'll see it when we resume after this word from Mid-South Wrestling.
This event is for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. In the red corner at 244 pounds, co-holder of the Mid-South Tag Team Championship, Mr. Olympia.
Junkyard Dog, a tremendous match and a tremendous man to tell you about it, Cowboy Bill Watts.
Well, boy, Pierce, I snuck out here. I wanted to be on the scene for this. A lot of people don't realize that Junkyard Dog asked for this match. You know, Butch Reed's been putting down a lot of stuff that the Dog has washed up. He's over the hill. He's out of shape. He doesn't have the endurance. And I think a lot of people, I know the Irishman Neal Boys Club is packed to overflowing here today because they want to see if Butch Reed has got any truth in what he's saying, because he now is the North American champion. And the Dog had gone to Grizzly Smith and said, I want the tippy-toe bandit, Mr. Olympia, because he's quick, he's fast, and he's in shape. He's more of the Butch Reed style. The Dog told me personally that he's into some different training tactics, that he bulked up and gotten real big and strong to face the men like Bundy and Kamala, people of that size and that strength and that bulk, but that he's going into a different type, an endurance type routine, because Butch Reed has the strength and the power of the big guys, but he's in the fantastic endurance type conditioning. It's a new threat, probably the most awesome threat ever to face the Junkyard Dog since he became the king of the hill, so to speak. Mr. Olympia, the tippy-toe bandit, a man who's no slouch. He's been the Mississippi State champion, co-holders of the Mid-South Tag Champions, and he's been involved in a lot of things. Plus, you got to know one thing. Mr. Olympia knows every move the Dog's going to make because he was formerly the Dog's partner. So he may know some weaknesses. You know, oftentimes, your own partner knows the weaknesses you have where other people don't. There, Olympia in for the sleeper. He's got JYD, and of course, JYD, a big, powerful neck. But that sometimes can work against you in the sleeper because you've got a lot more neck to cinch up on and make that hole tighter. The crowd chanting, as you can see, the appeal of the Junkyard Dog is not dimmed one iota. When he came, the whole crowd all throughout the Irish McNeil Boys Club stood to their feet and rocked to the music. They're chanting. JYD, JYD. He transcends race, color, and creed. He's everybody's champion. A man who knows where he came from, worked hard to get where he is, and the only way that they're going to put him down and out is with one tremendous battle. Mr. Olympia, oh, Dog really sunk one in then. There's that clothesline. JYD clotheslined him. Going for the count, but Olympia's out. Reverse headlock. Coming up next, Magnum T.A., the super sensation from Florida, the protege of Dusty Rhodes, will go for the North American title against Hacksaw Butch Reed as he makes his first television title defense. Then we got an interesting tag match. Steve Dr. Death Williams and Johnny Rich against King Kong Bundy and Ted DiBiase. And Bundy's been saying a lot of things about Dr. Death, about Oklahoma football, and about Dr. Death's career with the New Jersey Generals. And Doc has said a few things back about that he looked around the Atlantic City boardwalk for signs of Bundy, and there was no trace that would really fit talking about on television. Headbutt. Whoa! Olympia was grabbing for anything he could. He was hoping for a skyhook. He was grabbing, trying to keep from landing on his head on that concrete, but his brains were a little bit scattered at the time. Junkyard Dog pulling him in. Ricky Ferrar trying to break the dog, but Olympia. Olympia used a quick thinking and snapped the dog down to that steel cable. And the dog's ricochet as he caught it across the throat took Rick Ferrar. And Olympia is putting on that foreign object on the toe of his boot that he's knocked several people out with. We saw him this last week take Tim Horner. He goes for a drop kick on dog. He was trying to take the dog's head out. The dog got out of the way. Now the dog is going for the foreign object that's on Olympia's boot. The dog has got it. He's put it on his hand. Oh, that'll bring chills to you. The dog measures Olympia, and what an uppercut. What an uppercut. And the Junkyard Dog puts Reed, you better be looking both ways.
Bill, there's no way the Junkyard Dog is on the way down, and no way he's slowed up his tactics to find victory. We'll be back after this message from Mid-South Wrestling.
And now a title bout for the North American Heavyweight Championship. This event is for one fall or remaining television time. In the red corner, at 260 pounds from Kansas City, Missouri, the North American Heavyweight Champion, Hacksaw Butch Reed. And the challenger in the blue corner at 238 pounds, from Virginia Beach, Virginia, Magnum T.A.
A title match on Mid-South Wrestling, the North American Heavyweight Championship on the line. There you see the man with the belt, the title holder, Hacksaw Butch Reed, who will defend that belt and championship against the challenge of Magnum T.A. Bill?
Oh, boy, this is a great match. I'm telling you, I'm really looking forward to two fantastic
Joel
athletes.
Armstrong calls for the bell, and the title match underway.
Hacksaw Butch Reed has not held the title long enough to find out just how lonely it is at the top. But you got to watch everybody. He thinks he's really pulled something over on the dog. He's incorporated a little bit of help when he did it with one 420-pound mammoth giant King Kong Bundy and one mad dog Buzz Sawyer. But you got to remember that the very hand you feed is the hand that'll bite you when you're there. And Butch Reed better watch his back, watch everything. Plus, he's got the most awesome man in wrestling, the Junkyard Dog, after him. And he's also fired up somebody that he should have left alone, in that Jim Dugan, Hacksaw Dugan, with his feud with Akbar and his army. But Butch Reed says, I beat Hacksaw Dugan before to prove once and for all who the real Hacksaw is, and this time when I get through, he'll be calling me sir. Now that's just adding a lot of fuel to a lot of fire, because Hacksaw Dugan's a proud man. And he's a battler. So a lot of things happening here on Mid-South Wrestling. Side headlock. Magnum T.A., protege of the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. Fantastic. He can really use the atomic drop well. He does a belly-to-belly suplex that's lightning quick. So Butch Reed, you got to be really careful defending your title against a guy that can hit you with a pinfall that is such a sudden, quick maneuver. It's almost like the power slam of Ted DiBiase. I think the Junkyard Dog showed everybody just recently that he's dead serious about getting in the right condition to face Hacksaw Butch Reed. Reed right now is trying to do everything he can to not have to put the title on the line. Good drop kick by Magnum T.A. as T.A. shows that tremendous ability and movement. Joel Armstrong right on it. I don't think you're going to get Reed to submit, but you can certainly keep him thinking and keep him on the defensive. Great standby bout to come up if we have time with Steve Dr. Death Williams and Johnny Rich against King Kong Bundy and Ted DiBiase, the Big Cheese. A lot of speculation as to the Avalanche versus the Oklahoma Stampede. Oh, Reed used that forearm. He's really effective with that forearm shiver. He tried to take T.A.'s head off, but T.A. ducked it and moved in under him. That shows that tremendous amateur background. You see most amateur people with an amateur background are great wrestling skill. When the guy's on his feet and swinging, they're going to take him to the deck because it's hard for him to punch out when he's on bottom. Magnum T.A. First title shot right here on television. What a time, what a place. I know Magnum was really anticipating this bout. What an opportunity. Wow. Magnum is tenacious. He's really putting the power on that arm lock. You know, he gets that arm underneath the elbow and try to straighten out the elbow by the leverage of the leg and the arm, and it's really painful. If Reed didn't have such big, powerful biceps, he could probably hyperextend that elbow. Reed's in deep, so he's trying to force that arm in deep around his waist so that Magnum can't get below the elbow to straighten it out, and that's allowing Reed to drive him into the ropes. Joel Armstrong calling for the break. Now Hacksaw Butch Reed trying to deal some pain out and some punishment. I think he's decided you better loosen this T.A. up every time he tries to wrestle him. So far, T.A. has been a little bit quicker, maybe taking a chapter out of Hacksaw Reed's own book and verse about concerning the Junkyard Dog. Maybe T.A. is just a little bit hungrier and a little bit razor sharp and a little bit quicker. But, of course, Butch Reed has got the other side of him, the big, powerful side. He was a powerlifting champion on his college powerlifting team. Of course, he played pro football as a linebacker, and everybody knows if you're a linebacker in pro ball, you're a headhunter. And there he's showing that mean streak. That's the one thing about Reed. He seems content if he can beat him by intimidation, he will. But if they start making him look bad, he'll throw caution to the winds, and he will actually try to deliver some real punishment and hurt on him, as we saw here a few weeks ago when Wrestling 2 was battling him, and Reed just decided he didn't care about winning it. He just wanted to hurt Wrestling 2. And he came off the top rope with that diving body block, which was a disqualification, but it left 2 laying in the middle of the ring feeling it. Using the leverage on the rope. Magnum T.A. trying to straighten him out into a top wrist lock. Reed's got a lot of strength, and then he drove that knee into the kidney area. He's really bearing down here. Oh, he whiplashed Magnum T.A. Methodical Reed is. He came to Mid-South with a mission in mind, a dream in mind. He wanted to make the big money, to be in the spotlight, to have the accolades. Well, he's got a lot of attention. I don't know if he's going to want all the attention he's attracting.
Bill, with Steve, Dr. Death Williams, Johnny Rich, Rassin 2, Hacksaw Jim Duggan, a Junkyard Dog. You talk about heavy, about the crown heavy hanging on the head of a champion. Brother, he may find out that's the truth.
But you see, you just saw a maneuver Reed used that shows a tremendous athletic ability. Here's a guy his size, 250, 260. He drop-kicked Magnum T.A. right in the face. But T.A. firing back. Like I said, this is a great bout. Grizzly Smith, the matchmaker, this is one thing he exceeds in giving such fantastic bouts. Main events right here on television for those at home. And T.A. is really going after it. Magnum T.A., he senses victory here. He's got the momentum shifted. Goes for an inside cradle. Reed's too powerful to hold. Reed fires out. T.A.'s behind him. He's going for the atomic drop. He's got Reed up. The atomic drops him. Belly-to-belly suplex. There you have a new champion. Reed got it. Oh, Reed got out. I thought you had a new champion right there. That's the first man I've ever seen kick out a Magnum T.A.'s belly-to-belly suplex. Reed wants to recollect his thoughts a little bit. He bailed out of the ring. He's on the retreat. I've not seen Hacksaw Butch Reed run like that, but he's trying to get away from T.A., but T.A.'s bringing him right in. Oh, Reed held on. It came through. Reed's got the... Boy, you got to stay with it every second. T.A. Oh, good karate shot by T.A. Magnum T.A., this youngster is really impressing me here, Boyd.
And Magnum T.A. had him down for the two count. A hammer was coming down for the third, and that saved him.
T.A. missed that elbow. He's going for broke. Reed's punishing him now. Oh, Reed is taking him out. And Reed is bending that right knee that Magnum T.A. has, that knee brace and the brace underneath. And Reed has wrapped that around the post. That's not a disqualification. The only time it's a DQ is when you drive their head into the post. And Magnum T.A. going for that atomic drop. Oh, the punishment to that knee when T.A. went for his patented move. That knee was hurt too badly from being wrapped around that post. And although Butch Reed is feeling the shock to his spine, I don't know if T.A. is going to be able to get up and put any weight on that leg. Oh, Butch Reed caught him. And Hacksaw Butch Reed retains the North American crown, but I think today we've seen a new star born and that he pressed the champion.
Exactly, Bill, and a lot to be heard of from in the future from Magnum T.A. Tag team action coming up after this word from Mid-South Wrestling.
It's tag team action now for one fall or remaining television time. In the red corner, at 420 pounds from Atlantic City, New Jersey, King Kong Bundy. And his partner at 268 pounds from Omaha, Nebraska, Ted DiBiase. In the blue corner, at 295 pounds from Lakewood, Colorado, Dr. Death, Steve Williams. And his partner at 238 pounds from Tennessee, Johnny Rich.
688 total pounds, Ted DiBiase and King Kong Bundy against Johnny Rich and Dr. Death, Steve Williams, number 76 in the ring, Bill, the Oklahoma Stampeder, and of course, King Kong Bundy with the Atlantic City Avalanche. So a lot of action coming up as Johnny Martinez calls for the bell. Johnny Rich and Ted DiBiase to start it off.
Well, that's right. And that's 688 pounds. Bundy's 420, Boyd. And Doc is about 285. But Doc has wrestled some big men, and he's in college. He wrestled Tad Thacker, and he's wrestled Mitch Shelton and some other huge heavyweights. So he's not inexperienced against the big ones. There's been a lot of undertones about this match. A lot of things being said as DiBiase, of course, formerly of West Texas State University, being a Texan, and there's a lot of rivalry between Texans and Oklahomans. And a Bundy from Atlantic City, king of the boardwalk, and Doc had just played for the Atlantic City Generals. And Bundy and DiBiase been throwing a lot of barbs at Steve, and Steve is really wired and fired up for this match. They've been telling him that Oklahoma University and can't even win the conference, much less any important intersectional game, and that Doc was not smart enough to really be a great pro athlete. And oh, they've really been hammering him, and Doc is really fired up. He's proud. He's proud of the University of Oklahoma. He's proud of being a four-time All-American on Coach Stanley Abel's Oklahoma Sooner wrestling team. And you know, he's got a lot of just a deep-seated pride in Oklahoma. He loves Oklahoma. And so there's a lot of things going on. And, of course, Bundy saying Doc has stolen his maneuver because Doc Bundy has the Atlantic City Avalanche and Doc's Oklahoma Stampede. Johnny Rich out there, old Blue Eyes himself, has given the big cheese, Ted DiBiase, all the wrestling he wants right now. I think maybe DiBiase and Bundy thought that Johnny Rich would be the weak link of the team. But Johnny Rich right now has shown why I think the fans really care for him, is because he gives it his all. And he's really got DiBiase right now hurting. Oh, DiBiase not in too big a hurry. He wants to give a lot of room to Steve Dr. Death Williams. I don't see Bundy, Well, now Bundy's doing some talking, but we don't see Bundy forcing the issue and tagging in there, do we?
I believe he slowed down, Bill, since he looks across the ring.
Listen to the fans. They say, we want Bundy, we want Bundy. They've picked up on this rivalry, and they want Bundy in there against Doc. I'm sure Bundy, whoa, Doc just shoved DiBiase off. And you know, the people used to watch him wrestle at Oklahoma University. Doc didn't have a great deal of finesse. He just had that heart and that attitude, said, hey, you're not going to beat me. I'm going to tear your head off. And he's just that way. He just, that's about like his takedowns were at OU. He wasn't great on a pick single or anything. He just horsed you around and roughed you up. And, of course, the guy that took the NCAA championship for 1983, Bannock from Iowa, was a victim to Dr. Death in the semifinals in the championships of 1982. Doc beat him with a sternum injury and shoulder injury from the Nebraska game. So he's the kind of guy that even if he's hurt, he's ready to go. Got a lot of respect for him. And DiBiase is learning how to meet Steve Dr. Death Williams up close. Doc set for that stance, and DiBiase wanted to give it some room. Look at Bundy coaching.
Bundy's going away from him.
Yeah, Doc said he went down the boardwalk to check out Bundy's reputation and said Bundy had a reputation for being a bully around parking lots and kids' playgrounds and maybe stealing old ladies' purses or something. So Doc is saying some pretty bad things in return about Bundy. Here we go. You hear the sparks flying?
You see the Doc clap his hands when Bundy came in.
He loves it.
Tremendous.
They measure each other. Tie up, collar and elbow. Hey, they're both pretty cautious. They're both respecting that size and strength. One thing, you can never forget that mask. Doc found out once against Mitch Shelton when he went on under him at Gallagher Hall. And by gosh, if you get that. Boy, Bundy might have got a broken nose out of that one. Doc is firing away. Tag is made, DiBiase in. Doc is hammering DiBiase too. Johnny Rich is taking a piece of Bundy. Johnny Rich wanted some of that action. I don't know, Johnny. That Bundy, oh, they doubled up on him. Whoa, look at, Doc got him in sort of a stampede. Got a three. Doc got a three count, Dr. Death. And Johnny Rich beat King Kong Bundy and Ted DiBiase. He got a three count. Boy, you and I heard it. Ring it. They going continuing on. Bundy trying to get Doc and DiBiase. The match is over. Doc is running their heads together. He's not going to quit fighting. I think they just found somebody that just wants it a little bit more. I don't know what they're doing here. The match is over. There should be another referee down here trying to stop this thing. The match is over, and it's a victory for Bundy for Dr. Death and Johnny Rich. And Doc is still out after DiBiase, and Bundy's still in on Johnny Rich. A lot going on Doc had just shoved DiBiase right on his chin. The match is over. I don't know why there's not another official down here to help separate them. The crowd chant, we want Bundy, we want Bundy. They want to see Bundy get on back in there with Doc. I think Bundy feels he got a fast count, but he got a count.
And he's leaving the ring, and we'll be back with more action after this message.
This event is for one fall or remaining television time. In the red corner at 265 pounds from Russia, Boris Zirkov. And in the blue corner at 220 pounds from Houston, Texas, Tony Torres.
Tony Torres down to maroon tights and advance across the ring. His opponent from Russia, Boris Zirkov. Joining us now once again, Buddy Nichols, who will tell us about it.
I tell you what, boy, I don't think the wrestling fans have settled down since that last match.
Did Steve Dr. Death Williams, number 76, did he make his appearance known or did he not?
I think he made a good impression, too, on King Kong Bundy. Two big human beings in the ring in that tag team match. And as you mentioned, boy, it's Dr. Death Steve Williams did a good job. Right now we've got Tony Torres against Boris Zirkov. Zirkov in the red Olympic-type wrestling attire with the hammer and sickle insignia of the USSR on the front. Against Tony Torres, the popular Houston mat star in the maroon trunks. Torres jumped right into the arms of Zirkov with the backbreaker across the knee. And Torres right now in a great deal of pain. Zirkov working on the lower back area of Tony Torres.
And talking about that, you're exactly right, buddy. A lot of pain. Now, here's a man from Russia, and all Russians, regardless of what sport it is, especially in a combat sport such as wrestling, they're out to punish you. They're out to hurt you. They're out to gain a win at any cost.
That is so true. And, we talk about sacrificing bodies. They, too, are a breed of individuals that will sacrifice their body for just to deal out punishment. It is unbelievable that the way they like to inflict punishment on their opponents.
The neck over that steel cable, Zirkov on Tony Torres.
Goes for the reverse neck breaker. And Tony Torres, again, as we mentioned, in a lot of pain. Zirkov in command, goes to the second strand of rope, comes off with that big knee to the upper chest. Two, three, and that is it for Tony Torres. Boris Zirkov, the winner.
And we'll be back following this important message.
This event is for one fall or remaining television time. In the red corner at 246 pounds from Fort Worth, Texas, John Davidson. And in the blue corner at 250 pounds from Topeka, Kansas, Art Cruz.
Art Cruz shedding his blue jacket from Topeka, Kansas against John Davidson, hailing from Fort Worth, Texas. We saw John's bigger brother, Rick Davidson, in earlier match against the one-man attack of Hacksaw Jim Dugan, and now John Davidson coming in against Art Cruz. Buddy Nichols?
Okay, Art Cruz has the side headlock on Davidson, takes him down on a roll. Cannot get a pinning combination. Davidson, however, tries, but Johnny Martinez, the referee in the ring, counts only once, and both grapplers back up to their feet now. Davidson sends Cruz into the ropes. Cruz ducks under the elbow. Davidson tried to get the arm drag and takedown, but Cruz had enough strength to fight it off and wrestle him away. And now Cruz goes for the front face lock. Again, this is a one fall, television time remaining. And boy, I don't think we have very much time left at all. So we'll see if one of these wrestlers can come up with a quick...
Well, it's so important for a victory in matches like this, buddy, because if promoters are all watching, it gives the winner a chance to move up to higher spots on future cards. So a lot at stake other than just to have a match.
Again, both wrestlers, knowing they don't have much time, go to the offense quickly.
Next week on Mid-South Wrestling, Tommy Wildfire Rich versus Kamala the Ugandan Warrior. So Always something to look forward to.
That'll be good action, but boy, it'll be hard to beat the action we had this week.
There's no way. Every week just gets greater and greater. It's all here at Mid-South. That's where it's at.
We've got 2 minutes left to go. 2 minutes left to go in this match. Art Cruz in the black trunks against John Davidson in the blue. You know, boy, going back to that controversial match, Hacksaw Butch Reed defending his North American heavyweight title. He won it on a controversy down in the Superdome in mid-July. And he continues that streak, but he proved to be up to it tonight. Again, Cruz with the big elbow, trying to put John Davidson away. We are approaching the 1 minute mark as Cruz comes off the ropes hard and big couple of big forearms to the chest of John Davidson. Now the reversal, whips him into the rope, flying body press. Davidson down, one, two, not enough. He only
almost
gets the count of two.
Takes a three count in professional wrestling to gain a pinfall.
Two is awful close, but as you said, Boyd, it doesn't get you a victory, as both grapplers now working hard as time is running out on them. Again, Davidson into the rope. Cruz rolls him off into a pinning combination. One, two, three. Art Cruz comes away with a victory. Just as time is running out, Boyd, Art Cruz comes away with a victory.
He certainly did, and we want to tell the folks at home, next week, another great card here on Mid-South Wrestling. We hope you'll join us. Tommy Wildfire Reed.
That was the biggest ripoff I've ever seen in professional wrestling. I want that Steve Jackson Jeffrey is back in that ring. Nobody can take nobody. Ain't nobody ever had to stay.
And talk about stirred up. That's King Kong Bundy, and he's fired up. He said nobody does that to the Atlantic City Avalanche. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, thanks for watching. For our guest commentators, Cowboy Bill Watts and Buddy Nichols, I'm your host, Boyd Pearson. Goodbye, everybody, till next week on this same channel of Mid-South Wrestling.